This is the second part of the lesson Weather and Climate. In the previous class, we learnt what is weather, what is climate, difference between weather and climate, what are all the elements of weather, and we learnt about the role of temperature in determining the weather and climate of a place. And we also learnt about the different climatic and heat zones of the world. Now, let us see what is rainfall. Rainfall is a major source of water for all purposes on the earth. Rain is actually a part of a bigger part of the weather called precipitation, which means any form of water that falls to the earth like rain, snow, drizzle, hail and sleet. And there are three types of rainfall: convectional rainfall, relief rainfall and frontal rainfall. And you will be studying about the types of rainfall, clouds, everything in the next lesson, hydrological cycle. Now let us see, how is rain formed? Water is always moving. Rain that is fallen from where you live may have been water in the ocean a couple of days before. What a weird thought. Water can be in atmosphere, on land, in the ocean, and even underground. It gets used over and over again, though, through what is called water cycle. In this cycle, water changes from liquid, solid, and gas, which is water vapor. Water vapor then gets into atmosphere through a process called evaporation. This then turns the water that is at the top of oceans, rivers, and lakes into water vapor in the atmosphere using energy from the sun. This vapor can also from snow and ice too. The water vapor rises in the atmosphere and there it cools down and forms tiny water droplets through something called condensation. These tiny droplets then turn into clouds. When they all combine together, they grow bigger and are too heavy to stay up there in the air. This is when they will fall to the ground as rain or maybe snow or hail due to the force of gravity. Rain is a liquid water in the form of droplets that have condensed from atmospheric water vapor and then become heavy enough to fall under gravity. Rain is a major component of water cycle and is responsible for depositing most of the fresh water on the earth. There is a close relationship between temperature and rainfall distribution. Yes, only if there is high temperature, the water can get evaporated. Otherwise, evaporation is not possible. So, temperature here plays a major role in bringing the rainfall. Generally, rainfall is high in the equatorial region and decreases gradually towards poles. And this picture shows the formation of cloud. Rainfall is measured by rain gauge. One third of the rain gauge is sunk into the ground to prevent toppling, that is, make it stand erect properly, to be placed in an area free from obstructions. Now let us see what is air pressure. Air pressure is the weight of gases in the atmosphere pushing on the surface of the earth. Air pressure is determined by three factors: temperature, altitude, and moisture. What is moisture? The amount of water vapor in the atmosphere, humidity. What is air pressure? It is caused by the weight of all the air in the atmosphere pressing down on the earth. Why this air pressure is pushing down on the earth? Because of the gravitational pull of the earth. Air pressure changes with the height and also when air warms up or cools down. Changes in air pressure cause changes in weather. When the air gets heated, the air expands. And when it expands, it becomes less in weight and it becomes less dense. So naturally, it rises up. Whereas when the temperature drops down and when the air gets cooled down, the density of the air increases and it results in high pressure. Cool air has high air pressure than warmer air. Cooler air, that is why, weighs more than warmer air, because warmer air always expands, whereas cool air sinks down. Air moves from an area of higher pressure to lower pressure. Barometer measures air pressure, and there are two types of barometer: mercury barometer and aneroid barometer. And the unit to measure air pressure is millibars, whereas in mercury barometer, millimeters and inches are used as a unit. The air pressure is used is measured by barometer. The standard air pressure at sea level is 1013.25 millibars. At the Earth's surface, the pressure is 1.03 kg per square centimeter. The variation in standard atmospheric pressure is found both horizontally and vertically. Based on the level of pressure, it is categorized into low pressure and high pressure. Now let us see what is low pressure. Often we would have heard in news that the low pressure develops in Bay of Bengal or Arabian Sea. Low pressure area is an area in the atmosphere where the pressure is lower than its surrounding areas. In this situation, the wind from surrounding areas blow towards the center of the low pressure. And low pressure systems are called as depression and cyclones. And usually, the center of the low pressure system is called as an eye of the cyclone. Low pressure system is marked as L on the weather map. So this is the center of the low pressure system, and the surrounding areas, there is high pressure. And since the wind always blows from high pressure area to the low pressure area, the wind moves towards the center of the low pressure system. And what are the weather effects during the low pressure system? Unstable rising air causes unsettled and changeable weather. And these typical depressions bring cloudy skies, very low levels of sunshine, wet weather, that is rainfall, temperatures that are mild for the time of year, windy conditions, and the weather is often changeable. And these cyclones are named in different names in different oceans. Atlantic Ocean, it is called as hurricanes. And in Western Pacific Ocean and South China, it is called as typhoon. And in Indian Ocean, it is called as cyclonic storms. Whereas in Australia, these low pressure cyclones, depressions are called as willy willies. High pressure. High pressure is an area of atmosphere where the barometric pressure is higher than its surrounding areas. In this case, the wind from the center of high pressure blows towards the surrounding low pressure areas. High pressure system is called anticyclones. High pressure leads to fair and calm weather. What are the weather effects? Typically, these pressure belts bring stable weather conditions. The skies are very clear, bright sunshine, dry weather, high day and low night temperatures, calm weather, dew and frost, fog and mist, thunderstorms, and snowy winter. What are isobars? The previous class, we saw what are isotherms. Now, isobars. So, isobars, barometer is related to pressure. So, you can have a clue like this. Isobar, bar, barometer, that is for pressure. So what are isobars? Isobars are the lines drawn on a map which connects the places of equal air pressure. Isohels are the lines that are drawn on a map that connects places with equal sunshine. And isohides are the lines on a map that connect places of equal rainfall. So isotherms for equal temperature, isobars for equal pressure, isohels for equal sunshine, and isoheights for equal rainfall. Humans are not sensitive to small variation in air pressure, but the small variations in air pressure that do exist largely determine the wind and storm patterns of the earth. The distribution of atmospheric pressure is controlled by altitude. Yes, when the altitude increases, the air is less dense and automatically the pressure is also low. Atmospheric temperature, the high temperature and low temperature determines the density of air and naturally the pressure of the air. Air circulation, Earth's rotation, water vapor and atmospheric storms. Why do your ears pop in airplanes? As you go up in an airplane, the atmospheric pressure becomes lower than the pressure of the air inside your ears. Your ears pop because they are trying to equalize or match the pressure. The same thing happens when the plane is on the way down and your ears have to adjust to a higher atmospheric pressure. The pop that you generally hear is the opening of eustachian tube, a pressure releasing valve in your ear that connects your middle ear to the back of your throat. When on a rapid descent or ascent, your eustachian tube might not have time to balance the pressure, and when it does, you hear a pop. Air pressure and density decrease as you increase in altitude. So when you go up and up, there is less air. That is why the mountaineers, they carry bottled oxygen with them when they climb up the mountains. At the sea level here, you have 100% oxygen, and when the altitude goes on increasing, see in Mount Everest, which is 29,035 feet high, we have only 33% of oxygen. The highest ever air pressure at sea level was recorded at Agartha, Russia on 31st December 1968. The pressure was 1083.8 millibars. Lowest pressure ever recorded. The lowest pressure of 870 millibar was recorded at Typhoon Tip near Guam, Mariana Island in Pacific Ocean on 12th October 1979. Now let us see what is humidity. Humidity refers to the degree of water vapor present in atmosphere in gaseous form in particular time and place. It ranges from 0 to 5% by volume in atmosphere. Climatically, it is an important constituent of atmosphere and its quantity depends on the level of temperature. So, the level of humidity decreases towards poles from equator. Humidity is expressed in different ways. So, humidity is the amount of water vapor present in the atmosphere. You can just compare this to a dry cloth. You have a dry cloth in your hand and you have to wipe water. A dry cloth can absorb more water. But if you have a wet cloth with you, it cannot absorb more water. That's only like that. When the atmosphere is warm and dry, it can absorb more water vapor. But when the atmosphere it is already cool, it cannot absorb more water vapor. There are three types of measuring humidity: absolute humidity, specific humidity, and relative humidity. Absolute humidity is the exact amount of water vapor present in a volume of air is called as absolute humidity. And the formula is mass of water vapor by volume of air. Whereas specific humidity is the mass of water vapor compared to the total mass of air. Here you have volume of air, here you have total mass of the air. So what is this total mass of the air? It is nothing but the dry air plus the humidity. So specific humidity is mass of water vapor by mass of air, where mass of air is mass of dry air plus mass of water vapor. Typically at the surface, the mass of dry air is 1000 millibars and the mass of water vapor is only 10 millibars. And what is relative humidity? This is the comparison between how much the water can be held and the absolute humidity, actual amount of water vapor present in the atmosphere. Is how full the air is. For example, this glass can hold 6 ounces of water and it has 6 ounces of water filled in it. So the absolute humidity is 6 ounces of water and the relative humidity is absolute humidity divided by how much it can hold, 6 ounces. So 6 by 6, 100%. Now here the glass can hold 9 ounces of water whereas it has only 6 ounces of water. So the relative humidity is 6 divided by 9. So what is relative humidity? It is the comparison between the how much water or how much water vapor it can hold and what how much water vapor is present in the atmosphere. Generally, warm air holds more water vapor than the cold air. When relative humidity reaches 100%, the air gets saturated. In this condition, the temperature is said to be at a dew point. Further, cooling will condense the water vapor into clouds and rain. Relative humidity affects human health and comfortless. Very high and very low humidity are injurious to our health. It also affects the stability of different objects, buildings, and electrical applications. The temperature of air at which the condensation begins is called as dew point. Here is an example to show what is dew point. You fill a glass with water and place some ice cubes inside the tumbler one by one. At one stage, you can start seeing tiny droplets of water pouring outside the cup. And that water is not from inside the cup actually. That water is from the condensation of the moisture in the air around the glass. And it is called as dew point. The air surrounding the glass chills the air to dew point temperature. If humidity levels are too high, there is a risk of growing mold and bacteria, fungus, etc. Stuffy condition, and overall we feel very discomfort. That is why when we go to the coastal areas and beaches, we feel very discomfort and sticky. Because already the atmosphere is full of water vapor, it cannot absorb the sweat from our body. That is why we feel very sticky and uncomfortable. If humidity levels are too low, you run the risk of catching a cold or infection, dry and itchy skin, damaging your house wood, siding or paint. So low humidity, drier air allows moisture to evaporate, which cools the body very fastly. High humidity, the evaporation slows down, moisture limits evaporation, which makes us uncomfortable. The instrument used to measure the humidity is hygrometer. And this is the normal hygrometer. And this hygrometer, it has wet and dry bulb lid side by side in the Stevenson screw. What is wind? It is produced, the air in motion is called as wind. It is produced by the uneven heating of the Earth's surface by the sun. Since the Earth's surface is made of various land and water formations, it absorbs the sun's radiation unevenly. There are two factors which are necessary to describe wind: the speed and direction. The horizontal movement of air is called wind. Vertical movement of air is said as air current. The winds move from high pressure to low pressure always. Unlike other elements, a wind is made up of a series of gusts and eddies which can only be felt and we cannot see it. Winds get their name from the direction from which they blow. Winds blow from southwest are called as southwest. The winds that blows from northeast called as northeast. Types of winds: planetary winds, periodic or seasonal winds, and local winds. And these planetary winds are also called as permanent winds. Trade winds, polar, easterlies, and westerlies are the examples. These are planetary winds. Planetary winds are the ones which blow almost in the same direction throughout the year. So they are called permanent or planetary winds. Trade winds, westerlies, and polar easterlies are the types of prevailing winds. Seasonal winds are movements of air repetitively and predictably driven by changes in large-scale weather patterns, occur in many locations throughout the world. Seasonal winds are those which change their direction according to season in a year. They are called as monsoon winds. Actually, the word monsoon is derived from the Arabic word mawsim, which means season. These winds blow from sea to land during summer and land to sea during winter. So this is our Asian landmass. During summer, a low pressure system develops over the land, whereas still high pressure prevails over the water. So now, From the high pressure ocean, the wind blows towards the low pressure land. That is called as southwest monsoon. And during winter, the land gets high. Land, there is high pressure in land, over land, and low pressure over the oceans. Now the wind blows from high pressure land to the low pressure ocean. So these are seasonal winds called as monsoon. Local winds. Local winds are the winds blow over a small area only during a particular time of a day or a short period of a year. Land and sea breezes are example of these local winds. And there are different types of local winds, cold winds and warm winds all over the world. Pampero, Gregal, Vora, Tramontane, Mistral, Pohan, Chinook, Zonda, Lou and Sirocco. And this Lou is the hot and dry wind that blows in summer over northern plains of India. Sirocco is a Mediterranean wind that blows in the northern part of Africa and which increases its speed even to the speed of hurricane. And this Pohan is the wind that blows in Germany. And Pampero is the wind that blows in Argentina. And Chinook is the local winds of Rocky Mountains of North America. And Mistral is the local wind of France. The Beaufort scale is a scale for measuring wind speed. It is based on observation rather than accurate measurement. It is the most widely used system to measure wind speed. The scale was developed in 1805 by Francis Beaufort, an officer of Royal Navy, and first officially used by HMS Beagle. And this HMS Beagle is the ship in which Charles Darwin sailed to Galapagos Islands for doing research and where he found out the theory of evolution. And this Francis Beaufort, he is an Irish scientist. And this, under the Beaufort scale, the wind is named as light air, light breeze, gentle breeze on the basis of the speed. So from the calm wind, it reaches up to hurricane force. Meteorologist measures wind direction using wind vane or weather cock. Wind speed is measured by anemometer. And wind rose is a diagram used to depict the direction and periods of prevailing winds on map. Meteorograph or triple register is an instrument which records wind speed and direction, sunshine and precipitation. It also provides a graphic representation. And this is wind vane, anemometer, wind rose and meteorograph. Al-Balaki is an Arab geographer who collected climatic data from many Arab travelers and sailors and prepared this first climatic atlas of the world.